Hello friends, in the previous session we have started with the armature reaction concepts and we have discussed the shifting of the magnetic neutral plane due to this armature reaction. So just as a recap, the armature reaction was basically the distortion that the current in the armature causes in the main field flux. Okay, and the armature reaction is basically a function of the current which is flowing through the armature. Okay, so in the previous session I forgot to discuss one topic, that was for example we have told you that the armature reaction shifts the magnetic neutral plane, right? So when I select the brush position, you know that the machine might be working around its full load condition. For example, the full load current of the machine is around 20 amperes and the machine is working around at say 19.8 or 19.9 amperes, something like that. So why don't I keep my brush position corresponding to the magnetic neutral plane of 19.8 amperes? Because for example, for 0 amperes, this would be the magnetic neutral plane. And say for 19 amperes, this could be the magnetic neutral plane. Okay. So now why don't I keep my brushes here at this particular position and the entire things will get solved. Now I would like you to think about that and I will tell you the answer when the lecture is going to get over. Okay, so please think about that question, that is, why don't I keep the brush in the magnetic neutral plane corresponding to the full load current. Okay, now today we are going to deal the next topic of armature reaction, which is called the flux weakening. Okay, which is called the flux weakening. So as the name suggests, flux weakening means flux under the pole would reduce. Okay, so let us see what happens. Now this is basically a DC machine here, a simple DC machine, and we are going to load this DC machine. Let us take it as a generator. Theory is valid for motor as well. So here you are having the currents outgoing and here the currents are incoming. Okay, so if I draw the armature flux, it would look like something like this. Same thing we have drawn in the last session also, but let us draw it once again. Okay, so here it will be in this direction, like this, and here it will be in the clockwise direction, the armature flux due to the armature current. Now let us note this particular position here. Let me put a circle here. Okay, now if you look at this area more closely, what we can find is the armature flux is in this direction. So let me call this as flux armature, and the main field flux, which is caused due to the main poles, which is the north and south, is in this direction. This is the main field flux. So these are opposing in nature, right? So these are opposing in nature. So keep that in mind now. Let us take here, this area here, that is the other tip of the same pole. Okay. Let us just magnify it and let us observe that area also. So here, the armature flux is in this direction. You can see that it's in this direction. And the flux is also in this direction. Main field flux is also in the same direction. Therefore, here it is the additive nature. So here the fluxes are adding up. So in one pole tip, the flux is adding, and in one pole tip, the flux is subtracting. And both this addition and subtraction are function of the armature current. Now you might think some amount of flux is getting added up and some amount of flux is getting reduced. So effectively the flux should be the same, but that is not the case. Effectively the flux does not become the same because of the following reason. If you draw the flux versus current of the DC machine, you will get something like this, a graph something like this. Okay, so this is the point around which the flux inside the pole gets saturated. Okay, so most of the machine works in this region. So this is the area where the machine normally operates. So in that flux, the machine will normally operate. Okay, so you can clearly see, if I increase the flux, okay, increase of flux is never much because it has already touched the saturation. So even if I increase the flux a little bit, the flux increase is not very much. See, this delta phi increase is not very much. But if I take the same in the decreasing area, this delta phi decrease would be a lot. See, you can see as per the curve, the decrease can be a lot. For example, let us take 2 points here like this, okay, at the same distance, 2 points in the same distance. So this delta phi, which is the phi increase, and see this delta phi, which is the phi decrease. So delta phi decrease is far higher than delta phi increase, okay, because the flux can reduce how much ever it wants, but the flux cannot increase how much ever it wants because of the saturation. Therefore, delta phi d is greater than delta phi I. Therefore, the rate of increase or the amount which is getting added up is far less than the amount getting subtracted. Therefore, effectively the flux per pole would decrease, okay, due to this armature reaction. So let me just put it that here. Effectively, the flux per pole decreases due to armature reaction. So I hope the point is clear here. Okay. Now, what happens in the generator? Now, in generator, the EMF generated is a function of flux. Now, if the flux decreases, the only thing is that the EMF generated would decrease. Now, when we start discussing motors, you will understand that the speed of the motor is inversely proportional to the flux. Therefore, if the flux decreases, the speed would increase above its rated value. Remember that, above its rated value. And once the speed starts increasing or the load starts increasing, what happens is the motor tends to draw more current. And when it tends to draw more current, more armature reaction would happen. Okay, so if current increases, flux further increases and speed increases more. So in some DC shunt motors, what happens is that it really leads to a runaway condition, which is very dangerous. Okay, so I hope this particular session is clear. So we started with armature reaction. We discussed two problems of armature reaction, which was the shifting of the magnetic neutral plane. And then we have discussed today the concept of flux weakening. So I hope you have liked this particular session. Please press the like button. And if you like this lecture, please share and subscribe the channel. So I'll see you in the next session. In the next session, we'll start with the LDI by DT voltage problem. Okay. So I wish you all the best and thank you.